This is why we believe that the Stand for Truth Project is so critical. I told you about it last week. We are working with some Tea Party people. In fact, we just recently had a meeting to talk about the future. We want to replicate this across the country, but it's a very, very simple process. Instead of always and only fighting at the national level, which you got, you know, Media Research Center and others to do that, and maybe we'll end up doing that. But there's a lot of local media that is just as pernicious and yet penetrates into the community pretty deeply here. For example, here where I live in Hampton Roads, we've got the Virginian Pilot. Well, a lot more people around here read the Virginian Pilot than read the Washington Post. And so we went with and met with the Richmond Times-Dispatch. They were receptive. They didn't particularly like the fact that we were prepared to take action to protest and to contact the advertisers. We were explicit about that with them. They didn't particularly like that, but we held out the carrot and the stick, said we don't really want to do that. What we want to do is help you understand what you're doing is a disservice to the community because your reporting is biased. And as a result, I think I told you all, they brought on, and this is not the end, but it's the beginning at least, they brought on a staunch conservative onto their editorial board. So we've got to push back at the local level. It's kind of hard to push back against the Washington Post, but we're going to do that too. But with Jeff Bezos throwing money at them like throwing meat at a bear, they're gobbling it up, and as Dan just said, they don't care about losing money. When you got $100 billion, a few million here and there, what's the difference, right? But at the local level, we can have an impact because these are not gargantuan organizations with unlimited resources. They need all the subscribers they can get. They need all the advertisers they can get. And letting them know that they could have those people contacted and told that they're being biased, that they're not being fair in their reporting, is not something they want to hear. I can tell you right now, as a friend of mine said, we were talking about our meeting with the Richmond Times-Dispatch, that when we mentioned contacting their advertisers and we mentioned protesting, the body language changed dramatically. I mean, you could see it. It disturbed them to even hear it. And so we've got leverage. We've got people on our side. And they're used to only hearing from the left. They need to hear from conservatives. And that's what we're going to do. Like I said, we've got to replicate this across the country. We've hit the Richmond Times-Dispatch. We're going to keep following up with them. We're now going to the Virginian Pilot. They are our next target. There's some steps that have to be taken, obviously, and we've done that. You got to get your research right. You got to go in with ammunition. You can't just go in and say, we think you're biased. You got to go in with examples, specific stories that they've done that you can point out. Okay, let me show you what we mean. And that's what we did with the Richmond Times-Dispatch. We showed them exactly what we meant. And we're going to do the same thing with the Virginian Pilot. And we're going to do the same thing with other newspapers around Virginia. We're hoping we can raise up groups to do the same thing in their areas. So here again, you can connect with us or you can do it on your own, and we'll be happy to give you advice and counsel. Either way, just contact us at stand@standamerica.us.